Well, more than a week after devastating storms tore through Victoria's Dandenong Ranges, ADF personnel have finally been called in. 120 troops are on the ground to help with the clean-up and deliver much-needed generators.
Brigadier Matthew Burr joins us now from the Simpson Barracks in Victoria. Brigadier, thank you for your time this morning. Gee, there's a lot to do, isn't there?
Yeah, good morning, Carl. Thanks for having me. We've certainly hit the ground running in those affected areas, providing a wide range of engineering, logistical support and general support to relief tasks, which includes that engineering, generator support that we're putting out to the households without power and some welfare checks in those regions as well.
Brigadier, I mean, we always see the ADF step up in time of crisis. You were there for the bushfires during COVID and now this. What are the people on the ground telling your troops? What is the sentiment there?
Yeah, thanks very much, Ali. The troops that have been involved in this particular response were ones that were also involved and includes ones that were involved in the bushfires. And we're really working alongside the Victorian State Emergency Service, the CFA, and a whole range of state partner agencies shoulder to shoulder with them in this particular emergency as well.
Took them long enough to get you there. I know you're not going to comment on that, but in the coming days and weeks, there are challenges. I noticed, and you've already mentioned, that there are a number of generators being brought in. Is that part of the ongoing challenge over the next couple of weeks?
Yeah, that'll be the primary focus. We're in support of those partner agencies and working to the priorities of the state government. But yeah, definitely our main effort is to support those households that will be without power for a number of weeks, and where those residents need support with either relief packages or just assistance in making the area safe for them.
I'm just looking at the vision of the devastation there. It's going to take a long time. How long do you expect your troops to be on the ground and involved in the cleanup?
Yeah, the initial request has us there for a number of weeks, and we'll review that as we go through, working with the need as that goes on. And so we'll certainly be shoulder to shoulder with those other emergency services that are there and assisting as best we can going forward.
You've got some more nasty weather coming as well. Do you figure that you're going to need some more troops?
Yeah, we've always got an eye out for the weather and how safe it is in the regions that we're operating. The troops that we've got on the ground, and we've had troops on the ground and teams out initially with it as early as last Saturday. We're building on that throughout today. And then again, as we work with all of those other emergency services, we'll test and adjust and go forward with what's needed.
Brigadier, are your troops, are they door knocking? Are they checking on the vulnerable people there? We know that there was an elderly lady who was found just yesterday, I think it was, alone in a home without food or power for 7 days.
Yeah, and our priority will be set by those local community responses, and we're working very closely with the State Control Centre to identify those most vulnerable. So absolutely, we'll be getting to those most in need, and that's our priority at this point in time.
All right, well, the ADF, they wanted you there, and certainly you were ready to be there. We're thankful that you're there right now, because the people of the Dandenongs deserve all the help they can get right now. It's going to be a tough couple of weeks. Thanks so much, Brigadier. Appreciate it.